More geeky DIY projects and gadgets. Plus, Brendan brings his special brand of metrosexualism to the SEMA show in Las Vegas and will rock your lame ass with Guitar Hero, only the greatest game to ever walk the earth. Now keep the metal detector away from the zucchini in my pants. It's Attack of the Show!
Big up on this.
Hey, welcome to the show, Kevin. Yeah, you pumped?
Get pumped. I'm weird. Yeah. Welcome to Attack of the Show, everybody. Happy Monday.
Happy Monday to you too, man. How was your weekend?
It was awesome. Lots of partying, a little bit of dancing.
Way too much
of the drinking. Had a Guitar Hero party last night, which we are going to get to today at some point.
Fun. You know, Kevin, speaking of weekends, crazy happened over the weekend. I read something about it. A group of pirates, you may have read this story too in your local newspaper, a group of pirates attacked a cruise liner off the coast of like Eastern Africa, off the coast of Somalia.
Yar.
They had rocket-propelled grenades
RPGs.
That they shot at.
Yeah. Missiles, essentially missiles,
yeah.
folks.
Yeah, and even a few machine guns that they fired at the cruise ship. You know, everyone on the cruise ship was like, luckily the cruise ship.
Is that what they did? They immediately ran outside and was like, woo!
Well, I'm just, you know, that's my impression.
I like your reenactment though, it's good.
Thanks.
It's good.
But anyway, the cruise line happened to be sort of bigger and faster, and so they got away.
Yeah.
But it just goes to show you that pirates are alive and well, and they want our booty.
You know, I bet they do.
You know?
They had RPGs, they had machine guns, but they were using like dinghies with little single prop motors
to try and attack
an entire cruise ship.
Pirates always have been a shoddy bunch, you know?
Not the most reliable, not the most brilliant. But the thing is, I've been on a couple cruises, I've been blessed. But the last one that I was on was a Royal Caribbean cruise to Alaska, and it was like so boring. We were counting like the senior citizens' air tanks.
Well, to Alaska, Kevin, come on.
But I mean, it was bad, and it's like I wish.
I was on a Royal Caribbean once.
I hope and pray that pirates would attack our ship while you're there.
Oh,
like
totally.
At least it's better than the bingo or the horse racing around the pool.
Oh yeah, I was a teenager on a cruise ship. It's like nobody would give me liquor. It was awful.
Exactly.
I was like, somebody just kidnap me, please.
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 Take a pot shot at me with an RPG.
Make me walk the plane.
Well, Sarah, that's why I decided to start my own cruise line. It's I didn't want to really announce it. This is essentially my 2 week notice.
What an idea.
But this is my bad boy here. It incorporates Piracy of the High Seas.
What's the name of your cruise line, Kev?
It's Kevin Pereira Cruises, and the ship is Her Majesty's AK-47. This is the this is the Gunpoint Buffet, which is, you know, you have full access to it, whatever you need, 24 hours a day.
Hey, it kicks the ice sculptor's ass.
They make you carve your own ice sculpture at gunpoint. That's the .50 caliber. It's a little risque, but you might get hit with shrapnel, which makes it exciting.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, of course, at the end of the trip, we drain the pools, fill them with sand, and you get to dig your own souvenir grave.
That's so awesome.
Complete with the execution of one member of your family.
I love it.
It's a little something I'm working on. I think it's exciting.
Well, you know, best of luck, Kev.
Thank you.
We're going to miss you around here. But,
no, you won't. You won't even notice I'm gone.
That's true, actually.
Yeah.
So, you know, I hope that this entrepreneur idea is a good one.
Kevin Pereira Cruises.
Kevin Pereira Cruises.
It's creative.
Okay, so moving on now, Kevin, I want you to try on this jacket here. This is sort of one of our new nifty little...
Is that really a jacket?
It's really a jacket. Here we go.
All right.
See?
Okay.
So here you see the label on the back.
Yeah.
What this is it's the Scott E. Vest version 3.0 Finitech Shell. Has an
This is the 3.0. This has been upgraded. All right.
Has an optional zip-in fleece there. What's nice about it, though, is that it's one of these jackets where you put all your gadgets in. There's like more than 30 pockets to put everything in.
I got wires coming out of everywhere. I'm wondering.
So let's say you've got your new pocket PC or whatever. You can put that into one of the pockets of your choice. But now let's say that you're out of juice. Turn around. Show the folks at home. Turn around.
Okay, I'm turning. I was going to spin
clockwise. Show the folks at home that you have this lovely little solar area here. So you can power your gadgets, anything that is chargeable via USB, with your jacket. So
What? That's the firewire. Keep going.
Oh,
Keep digging.
Wrong one.
What is it? What are you looking for, really?
I'm showing the people at home the charger.
Want a candy?
So let's say that you want to charge this little charger is powered through your solar back, and isn't that fun?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not explaining
is like I'm already sweating like a pig. Like you'd have to pretty much use this only in snowy environments where it happens to be bright and cold.
The thing was, in theory, this is a really cool idea. $425, by the way, so it's not super cheap or anything. But I think first of all, you need sun, but you also need to not be that warm. So on the ski slopes, it seems to be a really good idea. I personally can't think of any other.
But, you know,
sun yet cold.
You could go up to like little snow bunnies and say, hey, you want to charge your iPod?
That's right.
Go digging. So, oh, feel the plug,
Although, for reasons unbeknownst to me, the iPod doesn't really work with this. There's some sort of like a, you know, how they have these little... Yeah, I know. So a variety of USB devices. However, iPod, there's something with the voltage here that just doesn't work. So,
So good for the snowy Explorer.
Good for... I like it. It needs some work, but it's very good in theory.
All right. I like... It's actually stylish, though, which I like.
You looked good.
Thank you very much.
You looked good. And everybody likes a solar guy.
Clearly.
For the environment.
It's environmentally friendly, yes.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, it's hot.
When I'm driving my Hummer, I'll hang the panel out the window and charge my iPod.
H3, they're smaller now.
They are. They still take as much gas. But one thing that's not as stylish as the jacket would be anything from the 80s. I think we agree. No?
What are you talking about?
Kind of
80s are rad.
They're not. Some people say they're coming back, but they're so not coming back.
They're rad in a, oh my gosh, that was horrible.
Right.
Sort of
and that's
yes,
why
absolutely.
I love... The 80s man. This is at hitthefan.com. I'm going to play a little sample here. This is a music video by an actor who claims that he is an 80s man. So there's a little rocking guitar in the corner of the screen there. And then a woman kind of comes out of his shoulder and sings to
why
him.
Why is he so 80s?
Well, because he's got a mullet.
Wait
for that.
What the?
Yeah, no, that was a candy heart coming out of his navel. It's a really nice party
because,
trick, actually.
Because, like, candy hearts were cool in the 80s kind of thing?
I have no idea.
Is that what this means?
I was barely alive.
Well, Kevin, come on.
But, like, he's like,
I mean,
vinyl.
You're talking up 80s, man. This
Aquanet!
We still use Aquanet in the makeup room every day. It's on your hair right now.
It's from the 80s. It's an actor by the name of D.C. Douglas. He also did narration for Night Court. So that's quite a resume.
Oh, Kevin, this is embarrassing.
Do that.
I hate 80s man. And I hate you for bringing him to us.
Listen, this is what's great about the internet. It allows anybody with a green screen and a camcorder to make a fool of himself. I appreciate it.
And fool he has made, 80s man, congrats to you.
All right, you should watch the music video. It's moderately entertaining. All right, maybe not. Brendan, did you like the 80s man? Did you see it at all?
Idiot man.
Oh!
Would be a better word for
that. Oh, zing!
Zing on you, Kevin. Zung.
So he's got a...
Zingo!
He's got a wig that's in a mullet and a wife beater and...
Yeah, from the 80s.
He's 80s man. He's 80s.
I mean, aren't the 80s rife for mockery anyway? It's kind of an easy target.
It is. I feel like those guys still exist. What makes him two dickers?
Exactly.
Because he's acting.
You weren't even alive in the 80s. What do you know?
Brendan, what's going on the show today?
I am bringing you even more coverage.
No.
From SEMA. That's the car show I was at all
Hooray!
Week.
Yay! More coverage from SEMA!
Awesome. Thanks, Brendan. We'll look forward to that. Now, with Attack of the Show on the air, you're never really alone.
No, you're not. You've got us.
This is a phone. We're going to take your calls from Make Magazine's gadget evangelist, Philip Terrell. They don't know. The number is 800-839-7880. And those of you who are too scared to use a telephone, I understand, can email us through our web form at attackoftheshow.com/ask-us.
Telephones are scary.
Talk to people. You can
also chat with us in our IRC chat room, too, if you're scared of phones and email. Just point your browser to chat.g4tv.com. What do you got there?
I was yelling about it. I'm still yelling about it today. Our lucky callers or chatters will receive Guitar Hero. Even the box is rocking.
You hear that? Kevin, Guitar Hero has changed your life.
It has.
Really?
It's sinking.
I'm not sure if it's for the better or not, but it's changed your life.
Yeah, you know. It's like when I discovered women, except this is available. Do not change the channel. This I command. Because coming up after the break, Make Magazine's Philip Terrell is here with a computer so small and simple, even a woman could use it.
What?
Stick around.
All right.
Look, we all know that machines will eventually develop their own intelligence and destroy us. But until then... they are our slaves. Back with more Tiny Gifts from the Future is Make Magazine Associate Editor Philip Terrell. Philip, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me again.
As always, you come with wonderful toys and I'm sure get you in trouble at the airport.
Always.
So let's talk about the Make Volume 4. What's the theme? What's going on with this latest one?
Our fourth volume is music, so all things involving music. If you're interested in making your own cigar box guitar, if you're interested in putting together your own band, if you're interested in putting together your own equipment for
from circuit bending to even sound activated photography, which we'll get to in a second.
Exactly.
Pretty much everything's in here.
Yep.
Awesome. Well, we love the Make. We can't support it enough. But now we wanted to highlight some of the stuff that you brought, starting with some MP3 players.
Yeah. This is one man's dream. This is a stay-at-home dad actually decided. You know, I like Pez.
That means he was unemployed.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay.
I like Pez and I like music. Wouldn't it be great to make a Pez MP3 player? And this is actually one of the first ones off the the assembly line.
So, did he go to Pez and say, here's the idea?
He did. He did. And it turns out they actually thought it was a good idea. And so he learned about fabrication and how to put all these things together. So we thought this was like a great maker story of just one guy who had this dream to put music inside of a Pez dispenser instead of candy.
But there's no delicious candy treats that come with this player.
Just lick the side of it. You'll feel different later.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, No. It's probably plastic residue that will give me dysentery. But okay. The problem with this there is that this is like generic head 01 on top of a Pez dispenser. Who wants that?
Right. Well, they started out just releasing the Pez heads back from the 60s. And one of the things you can do, and this is on magazine.com, is you can start to Dremel your own. So if you wanted to, you can pop off this head and take something like a Bugs Bunny, or there was an artist who did Fallen Rappers. There was a Tupac head
on his own.
So you can actually do your own little Pez heads.
Just Dremel it out. It's literally that easy.
Yeah, we'll have the instructions on Make on how to make the little hinge and make it fit well.
All right, so that's the Pez MP3 player now with interchangeable heads. Now this thing, they keep telling me this is the future of computing.
Right.
I think you even said that at one point earlier. And right now when I go to the website, it looks like it's something for Gen X teens when they're eating their Go-Gurt on their skateboards because it's so extreme, it makes noise. But it's actually pretty cool. Like, it's more important than that. What's this bad boy?
Right, so this is called the Fly. It's a pen computer, and we have this interesting article that we do each volume of May called News from the Future, and everyone's always talking about the $100 laptop and what it's going to be.
It's going to happen someday and solve poverty and world hunger and end tsunamis.
And this is actually a computer that's inside of a pen. And the neat thing about this is it has paper. And on the plane, I drew a calculator. So instead of having to buy a calculator, I can just draw a calculator on a sheet of paper.
You literally just touch the buttons. And you really just draw a calculator.
Exactly.
And there it is. We shot this a little bit earlier. And the pen, of course, it's actually a wireless pen. We have a wire coming out of it so we can grab the sound for the viewers at home. But literally, you're tapping numbers and saying, okay, I want to add 8 plus 7 times whatever, and it just is doing the math for you.
Right. And other things. Let's say if you wanted to make your own little music studio instead of having to buy all the equipment and do all these things, you can actually just draw your own music studio. So draw a piano, draw the drum kit, draw the tempo. And it's really an interesting way of using computers. So it's an interfaceless computer. The interface is you and your brain and the pen and the paper.
Now, how can it possibly understand or remember where everything is on each piece of paper? Or can you only use one sheet of paper over and over again? Or how does that work?
It has a 1.8 million square mile radius that it keeps track of.
Okay.
There's really complex things going on. But the result is simple. If you look really close on the paper, there's little tiny dots.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's how it's getting all the information. And you can do interesting things like here's the little Spanish thing. So I could translate Attack of the Show.
That's you literally write Attack of the Show and it will translate it into Spanish.
Exactly. And the other thing you can do, let's say if you didn't want to wear a watch, you can put this little watch sticker, and when I tap the watch, it'll
so literally just tell you the time by tapping the
sticker. Exactly, and you have other stickers that you can put on things. So it's really smart. It makes all objects smart.
$100 by Leapfrog.
Yep,
limitless possibilities with that.
Exactly, and it'll be open to hacking soon.
Oh,
so
good.
Stay tuned for that.
Good. That's what I want to see. Now, now down there we have a Canon camera that we've shown off before a couple times on the show. It's $1,000 or so, and it's got a little advanced speed light attachment onto it. The Canon speed light 580EX. $640, and this will allow you to kind of take strobe light photography to capture, images, at a fraction of a second, etc.
Right.
You've done your own hack for $100 that'll do the same.
Right. You can download the PDF to build your own circuit to make your own homemade flash photography, and we also have the kits on Make, and these are $99 and they're sound activated.
So you literally plug in the sound. You have a mic as well, and when the mic detects like a pop of a balloon or the pop of, breaking glass, et cetera, it will strobe?
Yeah, what it'll do is it'll strobe based on sound or it'll based on, a crash or a gunshot or whatever.
Goodness. And so these are pictures that people took using this actual hack. You can see the balloon, the deforming kind of in real time, right?
Yep.
So $100, and it works, and it can even attach to like a disposable camera.
Yeah, let's say if you didn't have a strobe, you can actually use a disposable camera as the flash itself and then use a digital camera. Yeah, so you're using, and these are great because they're made to be taken apart, not by us, but by robots or wherever they go.
The drones at Kodak.
Exactly. And so these are great low-cost ways, and it's all in the PDF on how to make these.
That's awesome, Phil. We took our own photo as well, so if you want to see kind of, you saw the balloons bursting. This was me getting water poured on me, and again, thousands of dollars versus $100. The results are pretty amazing. I think they speak for themselves. So, Phil, thanks again for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
Excellent, excellent toys. Again, everybody, Philip's going to stick around and take your calls, so get them in later on in the show. But really, get links to download the entire homemade high-speed flash camera article on our site. And today, thanks to Philip, we are giving away 40 copies of the newest issue of Make Volume 4. The first 40 people to get us their info will receive one. So the giveaway goes live. Pay attention at 7:20 Eastern, 4:20 Pacific. So get online, get us your times, get a copy. Now finally, someone had the good sense to invent a game that will make hordes of screaming girls want to throw their panties at you. Alex Rigopoulos, the co-founder of Harmonix, is here to talk about Guitar Hero, a game at which I happen to kick a lot of ass. Stick around. As co-founder of Harmonix, our next guest is no stranger to music-based video games. Alex Rigopoulos has created a game which can turn any Johnny PS2 player into a golden god of rock ownage. Alex, welcome to the show.
Thanks.
I have to say, some people have their Carmackian id Software idols. I wanted to whittle you a platform to stand on because Harmonix has pretty much changed, you know, the way I play games and the way my friends play games. I mean, really, it means that much. And do you realize that? Do you realize that your company has done that to some gamers?
We get a lot of kind of foaming at the mouth fan mail from people.
Okay, good, good. I wish I was, you know, an impressive 18-year-old girl, you know, that could really be a good fangirl for you. But fair enough. You're a fan of music, it's safe to assume, right?
I am. I mean, I have a bit of a background in both music and games. I mean, games I've just been playing since I was 3 and my parents brought home a Magnavox Odyssey console. But I've been playing music since I was a kid. And I started the company in 95 with a co-founder, Aran Agosi, who is our chief technologist. And he's also a great musician. And basically, we've got dozens of people in the company who play in bands and rock bands and play music. So it's really, we've pulled together that kind of culture and merged it with gaming in the company.
And Frequency comes out, you know, not a bad game by any stretch. It just, it didn't have it for me. And then, you know, what was the goal behind Frequency? What were you guys thinking when you released this? Was it more of a proof of concept for you guys? Or?
Well, you know, when we started the company, it had nothing to do with gaming. It was all about really trying to give people access to this kind of amazing, profound, primitive pleasure that comes from making music. And we did that for a few years in the late 90s before music games came onto the scene. And Frequency was our first stab at that. You know, it really became apparent that, like, gaming was the way we were going to try to bring this experience to a big market. We did that for the first time in Frequency, and Amplitude was really the first opportunity to kind of fully realize
Frequency
that.
was like a prison shank to the ribs, but Amplitude was a meat cleaver to the back of the neck. I mean, if you say it's your first stab, I mean, you got it right with Amplitude. It just clicked. I mean, what was the process with creating Amplitude? I mean, did you feel like that was it? Did you feel like you had made it when you hit Amplitude?
Actually, we felt like we were just getting started, and so
really?
We were really thrilled to have an opportunity to kind of take it to the next step with Guitar Hero.
Now, what were the challenges like with regarding a game like Amplitude? Is it hard to get bands and other musicians and stuff and acts on board with this? Do they understand the concept of, hey, we want to take your song and let people play it in a game?
Well, a few artists are very precious and protective about their music. They don't like the idea of, you know, letting it out for their fans to tamper with.
I think Eddie Vedder's afraid of video games.
Yeah.
Pearl Jam.
There's some artists like that, but a lot of artists actually get really excited about letting fans kind of get their hands on their music and actually experience it on a deeper level.
All right. Well, now you said it. It's come along, and I'm going to pull it up here. This is the pre-production. I think the buttons are swapped here, but this is the bad boy. Harmonix, Red Octane, you guys team up to create something. Tell me about the story behind this game, because I hear it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, well, we were approached by Red Octane sometime last winter. And I had a great meeting with their CEO, Kai Huang, where he came into the room and basically started preaching to me about how important music games were and how a big...
Did you kind of slide your resume across the desk and be like, hey, I'm kind of into them myself?
Well, I mean, he and actually all of Red Octane were big fans of Amplitude. And
great.
It was funny listening to this speech, because this is the speech I usually have to give publishers. And actually, you know, he just asked us, do you guys want to make a guitar game? And, you know... Hell yeah, we want to make a guitar game. It was easy, and so we were just off and running. And it was actually a great experience because they had a ton of hardware experience, so they took care of the guitar and did a great job with it.
Right.
And
I mean, this is an essential because I think for some, and I've tried to convince and I've tried to evangelize people when it comes to Amplitude, but there's such a barrier to entry when it was just, you know, shoulder buttons on a DualShock. But now they got this peripheral in their hands. I mean, this really kind of blows away the barrier.
Yeah, well, that was something, a hard lesson we learned with Amplitude, which is that once people actually tried to play it, they got hopelessly addicted. But when they just first looked at it, it was just kind of foreign and perplexing. So with our next game, we really wanted to make something that when people just looked at it, they immediately understood what it was all about and wanted to try it. And, you know, Red Octane, it was so clear from the first meeting that we had a complete unity of vision about what we wanted this game to be. So they pretty much just, it was hands off, and they just said, go make the game you want to make. And it was a great experience.
And people will see the game. We're gonna play in it a little bit, because I'm going to challenge you in an axe battle. But, I mean, it really does let you to perform these songs. And some are saying, well, there's been other guitar games in the past. You know, there's Guitar Freaks. They let you play it. What's the big deal? But Guitar Hero, to me, felt like a completely different game.
Yeah, I mean, there are a bunch of kind of gameplay innovations in it. But I think the more important thing is that it's not just about the gameplay. It's about kind of the essence and spirit of the game, that this game was going to be all about kind of the insane glory of rock guitar playing. So everything from the song list to the visual design is all about just rocking, and that's kind of the essence that we try to project through
right.
this game.
And plus tilt sensor and a whammy bar.
Yeah, this is another you way can't... that, yeah, Red Octane was great. We said, we need these things, and they said, they're going to be expensive. Do you really need them? And we said, yeah, we need them. And they
For
said,
the love oh, of rock, give me a whammy.
Exactly. So it worked out great in the end.
Thanks be to them for putting it in there. Now, I'd hate to do this to you since it is your baby, but do you mind if I just totally blow the doors off the studio and challenge you to an axe battle a little bit later?
Yeah, I mean, if you want to be made a bitch in front of all these people.
Oh! Oh! That's the gauntlet, my friends. Did you hear the thud? It's been thrown. Alex, thanks for coming on. We shall see who's made who's bitch. For more on Guitar Hero, visit guitarherogame.com or consult your local library. Guitar Hero is out tomorrow. I've said it 1,000 times. I'll say it a few thousand more. Go and get one for yourself. It's awesome. Now stick around. After the break, we will slice up the latest tech news and blend it into a high-protein, low-carb diet beverage we'd like to call the feed. And finally, believe it or not, a Matrix game worth taking the red pill for. I'll take you through the first 50 of Matrix Path of Neo. It's coming up. Welcome back. What could be better than tailgating before your favorite team's game? What, Brendan?
Hey, the Juggies are here.
Wow, look at that. How about pushing aside your pale drunk buddies in favor of the Man Show Juggies.
Woo-hoo!
This weekend, the Man Show is sponsoring tailgate parties with the Juggies.
Yes.
At major sporting events all across the country.
Everywhere.
There's going to be giveaways, games, and lots of drooling.
Yes, for a full list of times and locations, go to g4tv.com/themanshow. And, of course, tune in to the Man Show weeknights at 10, only on the G4. That's y'all. Now, if you've been anxiously awaiting a Matrix game that doesn't suck, well, then turn up the volume, because here comes this week's first 50. Ready for it, buddy?
The Matrix.
The Matrix. It's not just The Matrix, it's The Matrix Path of Neo. It's for the PC.
Now, we're talking about just the Matrix franchise now here, right?
Yes, yes. But this is the game that everybody's been waiting to play. I should say, I know like a lot of people at home wanted to play as Ghost and Niobe again. But this time they made the guy, do you know Neo? The main guy, the most important guy in the Matrix franchise? They made him playable.
Keanu?
Keanu himself. Take control of virtual Keanu. Essentially, this is the game that I think they should have made the first time, which is the most important parts of the movie, the most interesting parts of the movies that you remember. Now you get to relive them instead of playing the stuff that really didn't make it to the screen.
Quick question.
Yes, sir.
Why did they not let you play as Neo in the original game?
I'm going to blame it on the Wachowskis. I'm not 110%, but I think they wanted to do this whole, well, you get to play the parts of the supporting characters, which helped the main characters in the movie.
So
yeah, exactly.
Stupid.
If there's a car chase on a highway, you get to be the two characters that were driving behind the car
Stupid.
Chase on the highway. Exactly. So here's the game. As you can see, lots of training, more and more training. You know, the game kind of really brings you in and gets you up to speed with your combos, etc. But it's got this fighting system, which is very, very simple, but also sort of complex, where it basically feels like you're playing Diablo. You're clicking your mouse like crazy, but moves are happening. And you're okay with that, because it's kind of the trade-off you make for the Matrix game.
Do you get to decide when you do like the whole Matrix effect thing?
You do.
Yeah.
You go through a ton of
that
training,
cool.
And then you get deep into the storyline, and yada yada, so on and so forth. But, you know, you'll find that when you get weapons and whatnot, you get armed with focus. So you just press the shift button, you go into that kind of slow-down Matrix mode.
And you get the wraparound shot.
You get the old reach around. You can jump and boot kick people to the chin.
You get reach arounds in this game?
Absolutely.
That's
full
awesome.
Reach around support
really?
When you're in focus mode. It's one of the main reasons to pick it up, to be honest. As you can see, plenty of weapon
Look
play.
At that reach around.
You get lots of good weapon support. Yeah, swords mm-hmm. mightier there. Reach around to the gut. Cutscenes are there. They did try to do some of them in-game, unfortunately, which, you know, it's a mix of movie clips and in-game. I wish they would have just gone either way, preferably to the movie clip side. And the other thing is, like, they try to do this cloth simulation a lot, where it's like if a guy's wearing a headband, it'll kind of wave naturally using physics.
Oh, right.
Except with most cloth simulation, with other physics simulation, it's really wonky. Like, items will cut through characters' arms and heads and bodies, etc.
Lame.
Gameplay is fun, fairly simple, pulling off combos, again, nice and easy. You just basically use a lot of focus, mm-hmm. mash the mouse buttons, a lot of clicking. But then you get on to advanced training and advanced fighting, and you get all sorts of moves, and you kind of lock them, strings of combos, etc.
Is it worth training that hard just to get up to nunchucks?
Yeah, you don't really have a choice. You're kind of at their whim when it comes to the training. But the whole point here is that Shiny has done a great job with making the simple... Or the over-the-top, you know, kung fu moves that you're seeing here simple uh-huh. to execute. Now, some might say too simple, that you're really just button mashing, but
you know, I didn't mind that. I don't mind that. As long as it looks cool and it's kind of fun to kill these, you know, fodder enemies that come at you, I'm all for it.
Okay.
That's what I like.
Reach around.
If you still have a Keanu craving that needs satisfying, go ahead and pick up Path of Neo. Just do yourself a favor and grab a console version, Xbox or PlayStation 2, which should be in stores tomorrow.
Thank you, Kevin.
You're welcome, Brendan.
Now, with more beef flavor, it's the feed.
TiVo, the little device that has taken over your TV, and Yahoo, that little web service that took over your life until Google came along, are now joining forces. It's just been announced that the two companies will collaborate on a new service that'll let customers remotely program their TiVos through Yahoo. Now, Yahoo will also offer TiVo users access to photos, traffic, and weather through their TVs, something that would be revolutionary if not for a little something called the Weather Channel. Although terms were not discussed, analysts failed to see how TiVo could expect this partnership to generate new subscribers, yet they still labeled the deal, quote, incrementally positive. Who's doing the analysis here? Chris Gore? The DVD sucks, but buy it. Nah, just teasing you, Chris. You're great. See you tomorrow. Now, if you've noticed that your local area fanboy is unusually jittery today, it's probably because the script for the upcoming Halo movie has been leaked online, or his adult pass membership has lapsed. We'll assume it's the former, because word is that Halo may just be the movie to end the string of embarrassing video game adaptations, of which there have been many. According to those who've read it, it's true to the source, it's incredibly violent, mind-blowingly expansive in scope, and well-written. Somewhere Uwe Boll just collapsed in a heap. Wow, this is exciting news. Let's just take a deep breath here. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's plenty of time for Hollywood to screw this one up before it sees the inside of a movie theater. So just relax. Well, I don't know what we'll do. A 38-year-old Hong Kong man has been arrested for sharing bootleg Hollywood movies over BitTorrent, according to ZDNet. He's been sentenced to 3 months in prison. That's right. The man, Chang Naiming, was arrested after customs officials raided his home, but he pled not guilty to the copyright infringement charge. Now, obviously, this sends a message to BitTorrent users. Stop sharing movies. The music industry is too busy shooting itself in the foot to do anything, but these Hollywood folk ain't messing around. Adding insult to injury, Chan was caught after sharing the movies Daredevil, Red Planet, and Miss Congeniality. His lawyer tried to argue that watching these films was definitely the equivalent to 3 months in prison all on its own, and that was clearly true, but it still didn't really work, so... Finally, an 8-year-old Korean boy has just matriculated as a freshman the physics department of Inha University near Seoul. Now, since most of you were lost at the word matriculated, you can see why this is really big news. Song Yoo-gwen plowed through junior high and high school curricula in just 9 months, a process that takes normal Korean students, oh, I don't know, about 12 years or so, kind of like here in the U.S. He wowed university professors by correctly explaining the Schrodinger equation and was admitted into the physics program. Now, this is all kind of cute and funny when it's 8-year-old enters college. Ooh, when it's 12-year-old makes more money than you will ever in your life, not so funny, is it? So make your Doogie Howser jokes while you still can. It's going to be right in the show, just a few years. And in case you were wondering, that's today's feed. Thanks.
Philip Terone. Our viewers, Philip Terone. Ben joins us on the phone from Chino, California. Ben, you there?
Hey, guys.
How you doing, man?
I'm pretty good. How about you?
Doing very well. Are you a DIY kind of guy, Ben?
I kind of am.
Kind of. Well, that's good. That's better than not.
It's a good start.
I suppose. You have a question?
Yeah, my question is, what's the most impressive hardware mod you guys have seen?
The heated reel doll.
Yeah, that's...
No?
That's the second best one.
Okay, good.
You know, one of the ones that's... I don't think it's when you... count as an impressive hardware mod, but just what they had to do to get to it. The iPod Linux project.
You know,
they had to actually put this iPod in a box that was sealed, and for weeks and weeks and weeks, they would listen to the clicking sound so they can figure out how to actually get into the OS, and eventually they did. And now there's all these wonderful projects because of that. So I just really admire
I completely agree.
The methodical nature of the hacker who did
seeing the
this.
Photos of this thing in the soundproof booth was just ridiculous, the level that they went to.
Yeah.
Absolutely right on that one. All right, James joins us on the phone. We have time for one more question. James? Hello, James. James, you there?
Yeah. He's,
yeah, okay, good.
Right.
Don't hack your phone at mid-call. You have a question?
Yeah. What was the first electronic device that you hacked?
Well, there's so many. So many.
Do you remember your first?
Yeah. You always forget. You always remember your first.
You would hope so.
Yeah. Everything that's as old as new again. Circuit bending. I remember playing with my Speak and Spell, taking it apart, and tinkering with the sounds. And like,
back when they were new, not so much like when now it's cool to tinker.
No,
right?
Now it's hard to get them because right. There's the value's gone up. But like FM radios, AM radios, and I remember the Speak and Spell as being the ones because I could change things, put different wires, different resistors, and all of a sudden it sounded a lot cooler. And
then your parents got really ticked that you broke their alarm clock.
Yeah, I did break the TV shortly after that.
So. There you go. Philip, as always, thanks again.
Thank you.
Everybody, pick up Make Magazine. Do it. You need it. Now, sometimes the internet can feel like a vast, unwelcoming wilderness. But when we come back, our own little Sarah Lane will be your guide, protecting you, shepherding you into her gems of the internet. And Brendan has even more to show from the SEMA Aftermarket Car Parts Convention. Don't go anywhere. You know, Sarah.
Yes, Brendan?
It's day 18 of our ongoing coverage of the SEMA convention. That's the annual gathering of aftermarket car part professionals. And it's got a little something for everybody.
Mm.
Now we go out to Las Vegas and our very own Brendan Moran.
I know that guy.
Thanks, Brendan. Back here in Vegas at the SEMA Auto Show, where it's not so much what you put on your car that matters, it's what you put in it. And I'm not talking about air fresheners. So join me, won't you? A lot of these cars, nobody ever gets to drive. They're not street legal, or they're just too difficult. With the exception of my man, David the Fishman Revere.
What's up, buddy? I'm gonna show you guys the ultimate SUV in the world, called the Fish Edition. Open up my radio, play some tunes. I got my Motorola integrated with my iPod into the phone. This is the ultimate, most comfortable seat in the world, man. Now I'm gonna show you guys what I did in the back. How about we put a 22-inch plasma in the back so we can really watch some football games? Bigger's always better.
I don't know, some of this stuff just seems a bit much. This is a truck, if you can believe that. What kind of stuff in the neon category are people putting on their cars these days?
We're the leaders in the neon product, but what's coming up strong is the LED product.
Is this stuff legal?
In some states it is, like California, you do not bother. Some colors that you might bother you with. You have to really check with your local laws.
There's a lot of different accessories on all types of cars. The boys from Hazard County were gracious enough to donate their bow and arrow set with TNT on top of it. There's a lot more than just this, though. Although the stars and bars, I think, are a nice touch.
So you can stop me from getting speeding tickets, is that right?
Yes, sir, that's correct. The LE30 will receive a pulse from a laser gun and combat that laser gun by firing a laser of its own. And so I'm driving down the road.
Right.
Is this thing working automatically?
Yes, it's on the moment you start your car.
It's jamming the police radar, right?
The police laser.
Laser.
Yeah. After 5 seconds, our unit will shut itself down to limit suspicion.
Are these legal?
Laser's defense systems are legal in most states. I do recommend that you check your local laws before using any of these products. You don't want any hassles.
Damn you, Arkansas.
Wow.
More SEMA tomorrow.
I can't wait.
I look for the world's most expensive rim, and I find it.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Now, well, thank you, Brendan. That was great. Because time doesn't waste itself, let's take a look at today's gems of the internet now. So, Brendan, I came across something that made me realize that I have been showering all wrong for many, many years. And so have
forgetting,
you.
Forgetting the soap.
No. Well, yes, but that has been eradicated. What hasn't is the fact that I am drying I'm drying my face and my hiney with the same towel day after day. So you don't want
to. You do that?
You do too.
No, what are you talking?
Everybody does. Anyway,
no better than that.
For those of us, which is everybody.
That's gross.
Are you telling me you use a different towel for
your face? Well, yes. I have a
hiney
towel, smaller.
You're lying, and that is why you need something called the butt face towel. See, this has a very clear indicator of where you should dry your face and where you should dry your butt. Okay.
The spot that says butt is.
The spot that says butt is for the butt. So it's really easy to use. And if you like the way that that works, you can also get butt face soap. Because if you think about it, that's almost more important.
What about something that would give
you. Only $4.99, it's in stock.
Give you the face in one spot and then the taint in another.
I don't even know what that means.
Okay. Sorry.
That's weird. Okay, moving on. Remember when you used to live in San Francisco?
I do.
I used to live in San Francisco too, but I never remember San Francisco being made of Jell-O. But it is now gem number two.
The city itself?
The city itself. Yeah. Well,
look at that.
It's a representation of it. Yeah, so here's the city itself, kind of that aerial view of downtown. Jeez. If you go next, there's Alamo Square. I used to just live right up the
is
street
that the Seven
and
Sisters?
To the left. The Painted Ladies.
Whatever.
They're the Painted Ladies. And, of course, we've got City Hall.
Can you eat said Jell-O?
Well, Jell-O's edible, isn't it, Brendan? Isn't it?
Isn't it? Yes.
All right. And finally, as we saw with the 80s, man, things get stupider and stupider on the internet these days.
No.
I'm not sure that we can top ihumpthings.com. Yes, this is a site put together by a very brave man who has photographed himself humping all sorts of things. For example, a car.
We should have him on the show.
I know, totally. Or a sort of like weird, you know,
he's kind of standing next to it.
Used
though.
To be at Universal Studios. No, he's humping it. He's totally humping it.
You can get a leg
well,
up
then he's
it.
Certainly humping this tree, isn't he?
Certainly is.
He certainly is.
Looks like he's finishing
I
on
hope,
that tree.
I hope the tree has little coconuts too, just for you know a little extra. And if you want to, Brendan, if you want to, you can submit your own hump, and he'll put it up
there.
No,
thank you.
So you guys can be friends. Whoa! Oh my God.
What's that? Read.
You can find all my gem links plus the gems of yesteryear at attackoftheshow.com. Now, coming up after the break, Kevin will take on Guitar Hero creator Alex Rigopoulos in a finger-bleeding battle of sonic domination to determine once and for all who the rockiest fake guitar player on extended cable is.
You alright?
I'm not sure. I'm fine. How are you? But first, here's a word from our sponsor.
Gems of the Internet is brought to you by Laser Tag, the ultimate game of electronic tag.
On the next Attack of the Show, Master of Horror Steve Niles scares the crap out of us with Masters of War. Good thing I always wear my adult diapers. And if you want to see something really scary, check out Chris Gore in DVD Doomsday. I mean, his knowledge of movies is really scary, not the guy personally. And it's Vegas, baby. Author Ben Mezrich shows us how to bust Vegas and turn your next trip to Sin City into a moneymaker. That's what you'll see next time you watch the show. Now, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to rock?
Woo!
Are you ready to watch two nerds play a rhythm game?
Hey.
Well, if so, please welcome Alex Rigopoulos and Kevin Pereira performing Fellas.
Yeah. Woo. All right, you ready for this, sweetheart?
I'm ready.
Little duel mode. Let's see what we got here. Oh. Whatever. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna dedicate this song to my MySpace girlfriends. I love you, sir. 16. Wait, 2 years. It's 2 years. It's fine.
So pick one up and rock out.
Woo!
Don't move. I'm serious. You move, Pereira starts cracking skulls. You don't want to see television. Oh my God, get away from me.
You're right.
When we come
it's
back.
It's a little intimidating. I'm close,
actually,
isn't it?
Actually, you look pretty good in those pants.
Yeah,
when we come back, we're going to answer emails and check in our IRC chat room. Don't move. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Go buy the game. Attack of the show, baby.
Nobody tell you G4 never did nothing for you. G4 is giving 4 grand prize winners a trip for 2 to Game in San Francisco, the Games and Music Experience. It's happening Friday, December 2nd, and Sunday, December 4th, at the Moscone Center in San Francisco. It's 3 days of wall-to-wall games and music and assorted craziness. So see it first, play it live at Game. Enter online at g4tv.com/game from November 7th to November 11th. It's all good.
It's hard to look at you right now.
It's hard. You know, the pants were coming off. I wanted to do more jumps and kicks. I apologize to my lady
friends. You know, you're really good, though.
Are you wearing
though.
Mascara right now?
I was for most of the show, actually.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
It's kind of like teal,
it
too.
It burns a little bit, actually.
Yeah.
We have some chat questions.
Welcome to girlhood.
These are my guitars.
Bomberman Andy wants to know, if you could play Guitar Hero with any rock star, who would it be?
Alex,
I know what Kevin's answer
Alex
is.
Alex Rigopoulos.
Who
hands
else?
Down. What, I don't play Guitar Hero with any rock star? What, you're thinking the guy from Dredge, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. It'd probably be you know, Jimi Hendrix.
Steve Vai?
Steve Vai's not bad.
No,
not bad.
Best fingers.
Hendrix is better, though. By the way,
because he's dead.
I really can't play the game, I promise.
I think he choked from his own vomit.
No, he didn't. prescription drugs.
Oh, oh really?
Janis Joplin did that.
Oh, that's
fantastic.
True. Yeah.
Yep. Anything
Chris,
else?
Chris Potatoes wants to know, who do you think what do you think will come of Bono joining forces with Pandemic and BioWare Studios? Nothing good.
A lot of tree-hugging games, you know, run around, find a tree and give it a big old bear hug.
Well,
and
probably solve really, world hunger.
He's a bit. The tree
little
hugger,
bit.
That's not really his crusade, is it?
What's his thing?
Hunger.
Yeah.
Oh, hunger.
Yeah.
He didn't want the kids to go hungry.
Developing world
Sunday
poverty.
Sunday, buddy, Sunday, you know?
Oh, okay. Yeah. It's been a feed game
yeah.
where you feed
Dead
people.
End streets. Mm-hmm. Iceborne wants to know, do the host think Guitar Hero would be even cooler with an online mode?
You know, I gave Alex a little bit of a guff. For the lack of an online, because Amplitude was such a great online game, but I don't doubt that there will not be a sequel. I'm not confirming or denying, I'm just personally saying I bet there will be one, and I bet it'll be online.
I don't know, though. Doesn't that sound messy? All the bad guitar players out there?
Yeah, but if they all get dressed up, have some fun with it, why not?
I guess
Guitar
so.
Hero Party in my house. Woo!
G455D wants to know, what happened to the Max Payne movie, huh?
You know, yeah, remember there was that fan film
That's
that was released a while
question.
Back, like the hero thing? I don't know. Did you turn on the role, Brendan?
I did turn it down.
Why? Now, why is
well,
that?
Well, because a lot of, you know, video games being made in the films today, it's just not a very viable career choice,
sure.
I think. You know what I mean?
With an actor of your caliber.
Plus, they offered me something like $13 million.
Well, come on.
And right? I mean, I know they're lowballing me,
right.
And that's
you
fine.
You have to fight back.
We play the game, so we're in development, you know. I don't know, have they called you? Because I said, maybe, you know, I know a guy. He's a nobody.
Right.
But
I'm an upstart, as they say.
Well.
Up and comer?
Nobody.
That's a whole other series.
Nobody?
Yeah, I haven't gotten a call yet.
Okay.
Phone hasn't rang.
Well, I'll do what I can for
hasn't
you.
Rung.
Phone has not rang.
Has it not ringed at all?
There has been no ringage.
Phone hasn't rung.
Past tense.
All right.
Smash guitar.
Okay,
is that
that's it?
It.
Yeah, I think so.
All right. Go home, folks.
Big thanks to our guests, Philip Terone and Alex Rigopoulos. Oh, you guys stay here. Go home.
Ah.
Computers on Attack of the Show provided by Intel. Game on. Power up. Take control with the Intel Pentium Processor Extreme Edition.